Hello everyone, so today we are going to look at how to model uncertainties and have better insights on how these uncertainties would affect the performance of your asset. Uncertainties come in many forms, so today we'll look specifically at weather uncertainties. For example, severe weather events like strong waves on offshore facilities or severe storm and flood to onshore facilities. Now, for seasoned Maros and Taro users, you will know that the fundamental to Maros and Taro simulation are events. For first-time users to our software, in simple terms, Maros is event-driven. The key inputs to the RAM analysis are definition of events and the consequence when the event happens. The combination of events and the consequence determine the system's effectiveness. And in our software, we have three basic types of events. The choice of whether to use a scheduled or unscheduled element depends on whether you want the failure to happen at specific time or not. If you want to combine the effects of two failures, say for example, any two failures happening at the same time, you can use the conditional element. So let's investigate the case study. What I have in this model are a couple of well pads which will converge to a gathering facility prior to separation. And what I'm trying to do here is to say, what is the impact of flooding to the wells and how does it impact the overall performance of the entire network? The model has been simplified to consider two external uncertainties. One seasonal change and the other is the rainfall. In this case, I would like to model in a way where different seasons would have different probabilities of rainfalls with precipitation rate above 30 millimeters per hour. I'm assuming at this rate, it would cause a flood in these locations. We have set up four seasons and in each season lasts 3 months. To do this, we use schedule element to set up the recurrent event and the time when this event is valid. We have used equipment item to represent random failures, and for this case it will be the random occurrence of precipitation rate above 30 millimeters per hour, and for each season will have different effect towards the duration of when the well pad is down. The hazard rate for autumn as an example is a probability of 12 occurrences. We have set up conditional logics for each of the season, and the effect type for these condition logics is concurrent event because we want this to last as long as the initiating triggers. And the initiating triggers would be the seasonal events and the high rainfall events. And the conditional logic will only be true when both events happen concurrently. Once this conditional logic is triggered, the well would experience a 15% production loss. And finally, let's look at the results. And what we get from this setup is flooding events contribute to around 0.15% of the overall losses in 10 years. So with this in mind, is this loss contribution significant enough to set up a flood mitigation infrastructure, for example? So this demo is for an onshore scenario. Now, if you are modeling an offshore facility, then the scenario would be impact from bad marine conditions or even typhoons that would reduce or, in the worst case scenario, shut down the production for the satellite platforms as an example. I hope you find this demo useful. Thank you for watching, and if you have any questions or like to get in touch, please email digital@dmvgl.com. Take care and bye for now.